So, David's briefly said who we are. I'm Paula, and Ken, my husband. We jointly run our own B&B in the Forest of Dean, called Dean Valley Panorama. We also run courses and do on-site consultancy for people starting up B&Bs or holiday lets. And last year, we appeared, well, I appeared in the Premium magazine, well, so this year, actually, and we were on Radio Gloucestershire, BBC Radio Gloucestershire, both for our Pillowtalk training business and our B&B. And incidentally, both of those things were as a result of me tweeting. We are an award-winning B&B. We've got awards on booking.com, TripAdvisor, Trivago, and our reviews are mostly excellent. So before we actually know when everybody used to phone you up or come walking in through your front door, and you would put your bookings in your front desk or even in your diary. And then you might have had a website and people may have been able to book through it. So the reservations came in and you would update your rates and availability. Then came along all the online travel agents, like the booking.coms and Expedias, with their reservations and your updates. Then came TripAdvisor, and they originally, if you didn't have a business listing, would refer everybody through to the OTAs. But now you can have them refer to your own website. So with all of this going on, you need your channel manager to update your rates and availability and reservations. And then came social media. And now social media can be driven straight to your website and to your booking engine, and people can book through that route. And last but not least, you have the Airbnbs, and for the holiday letting people, a customer goes to them, they come to you, and then you can update your rates and availability, and your channel manager can update that direct to them. And also there are other distribution systems like tourism associations, other small websites that will link all into that channel manager. So if you don't have a channel manager, it's difficult to manage everything. So your own...
We've been renovating properties. We've renovated about 12 different properties. So we have a lot of knowledge about what it costs and how you convert things. We ran holiday lets for about 5 years, different holiday lets, and we've been running a B&B now for 3 years. So that's kind of how we got here. We formed Pillowtalk Training about sort of 18 months ago, so we're just sort of getting going really in this area. My presentation will probably be quite different to most of the ones you've had, because most of the other ones are about people selling a product or a service. And I'm just here to try to give you independent advice. And if you're interested in what we have to tell you, then yeah, you might want to. We had some opportunity for the Rugby World Cup. Cheltenham Festival is something that comes around every year. It might be a surfing event in Cornwall, something like that. They're all things that you can take advantage of. I mean, if you're really lucky and you live sort of close enough to Cheltenham during that festival week, there is an opportunity for people to earn five times what they would for a room, people will pay. I mean, we live about 25, 28 miles from the race course, and we're on the wrong side of the Severn, and we never get any bookings for Cheltenham. Even though on the other side of the Severn, which is called the Cotswolds, you could be 28 miles away there, and people will still book you there, but not in the Forest of Dean. They think, where the hell is that? That's like, I'll get lost there, or never come back. So you've got that sort of interest. TV shows, this is a really good thing for the Forest of Dean, where Star Wars, Doctor Who, Atlantis, there are more, have been filmed in Puzzlewood, which is a fantastically natural forest area. And it does pull in a lot of people, and as a result of Star Wars being out this year, it's fairly likely that
a lot of certainly Chinese and many European fans of Star Wars and American people will come to the area, and people will benefit with better representation. Yeah, we do. And we find that probably, you know, 95% of them are quite happy about that. Probably 5% would prefer you didn't. And we don't insist. So we say, if you don't want to, we'll just come down in the morning and we'll sort you out, as it were. But we try to sort of position it that if they use it, they're much more likely to get their food quicker and fresher. And so that's why we do it. And yeah, we do. And we find that probably, you know, 95% of them are quite happy about that. Probably 5% would prefer you didn't. And we don't insist. So we say, if you don't want to, we'll just come down in the morning and we'll sort you out, as it were. But we try to sort of position it that if they use it, they're much more likely to get their food quicker and fresher. And so that's why we do it. And